Hello and welcome to Mathsmerizing.com. The topics that we'll study today are now any inequality which is of the form fx upon gx greater than 0 or less than 0, greater than equal to or less than equal to is a rational inequality. So I'll take up as a very simple example. X is greater than 1 by x. So this question is an example of a rational inequality. So we have some expression in the numerator, we also have some expression in the denominator. Now, how do we solve any rational inequality? Steps to solve any rational inequality, they are almost the same. Now, first thing that we need to keep in mind is, I cannot cross multiply this x on the left hand side. So we cannot cross multiply in case of rational inequalities unless we are sure about the sign. So in this case, I cannot cross multiply. Maybe if the case is x is greater than 1 upon x square plus 1. So now when I know this x square plus 1, it's always positive. Now I can cross multiply. I can write x into x square plus 1 is greater than 1 because here I know it's always positive. So when I multiply with a positive number, sign doesn't change. So here multiplication is allowed. But in this case, if I'm going to cross multiply x square is greater than 1, here cross multiplication is not allowed. Now, how do we solve such question? Now, again, there are like same 5 steps. So the first step is make right hand side 0. So I'll make right hand side 0. X minus 1 upon x is greater than 0. Then factorize x square minus 1 upon x is greater than 0. So I'll simply write x minus 1, x plus 1 upon x greater than 0. Now find roots. Now in this case, in case of a rational inequality, I'll find roots of both numerator and also roots of denominator. So I need to find roots of numerator as well as roots of denominator and place all of them on a number line. So when I look at the roots, so the roots are x is 1, minus 1 and 0. So I'll actually put all the roots on a number line. So first minus 1, then 0 and then plus 1. Now then again, I need to find sine of the rightmost interval. Now what about the sine of the rightmost? So here coefficient of x positive, positive, leading coefficient positive. So plus, plus and plus. So rightmost is plus. So this is plus, this is minus, this is plus and this is minus. Now what do I need? Now I'll go back to my inequality. It says greater than 0. Greater than 0 is obviously positive value. So I need plus. So this is from minus 1 to 0. And then from 1 to infinite. And then there's no equality sign. So I'll simply write x belongs to from minus 1 to 0 union from 1 to infinite, right? There are only two differences vis-a-vis polynomial inequality and rational inequality. And the one being here, we'll take the roots of both numerator as well as denominator. So numerator is equal to 0 and denominator equal to 0. Now the second difference is when I have an equality sign. Suppose I have the same question, but here suppose we have an equality sign. X square is greater than or equal to 1 by x. So I'll solve the question in the same way. X minus 1 upon x greater than or equal to 0. Here also will be greater than or equal to 0. Here also will be greater than or equal to 0. Here again I'll take numerator and denominator. Here again I'll get all the three roots as minus 1, 1 and 0. I'll put them on another line. So now what's the difference? The difference being, now there is an equality sign. So previously there was not an equality sign, so I could put all the open circles there. Now here we have an equality sign. So now if I put x as 1, I'll get 0. If I put x as minus 1, then also I'll get 0. But if I put x as 0, I won't get 0, I'll get infinite, either plus infinite or minus infinite, depending on the question, right? So that means if there's an equality sign, then we'll represent all the roots on a number line like we did previously, but then we can only include the roots of the numerator. We cannot include the roots of the denominator. So that means, what are the roots of the numerator? So I'll include minus 1 and plus 1, but I'll exclude 0. So in this case, the answer will be x belongs to minus 1 to 0, minus 1 included, 0 not included, union, and then from 1 to infinite. So we are going to represent all the roots on a number line. I'm going to represent 1, minus 1 and 0 also, but then when I'm going to include them, I'll just include the roots of the numerator. I'll not include the roots of the denominator. So this is how we are going to solve these questions. So let me take up another example. X plus 4 upon x minus 2 is less than 2 upon x plus 1. And I need to solve this question. Now I cannot cross multiply because sign of these both the expression they'll change. So I cannot cross multiply. So I'll take it on the left hand side. I'll write x plus 4 upon x minus 2 minus 2 upon x plus 1 should be less than 0. So now I'll solve it. So x minus 2, x plus 1, x plus 4, x plus 1 minus 2, x minus 2 is less than 0. So what I'll get? I'll get x square minus 4x minus x plus 5x plus 4 and minus 2x plus 4 upon x minus 2 x plus 1 is less than 0. So I'll simply write it as what? X square plus 3x plus 8 upon x minus 2 x plus 1 is less than 0, right? So now I try and factorize this one, x square minus 3x plus 8. So when I look at this expression, what's the value of d here? So value of d is minus, b square is 9 minus 32, so which is less than 0. Now coefficient of x square is positive, so this is always positive. So rule number one says I'll remove this expression from the inequality. So that means the two roots that I have here is minus 1 and 2. And then sign of the rightmost is plus, minus, and plus. And I'll need what? Less than 0. Less than 0 is minus. So answer to this question is x belongs to minus 1 to 2 and minus 1 and 2 not included. Now with rule number 1, we'll use rule number 2 because there is not an equality sign. But because this expression doesn't have a real root, so there is nothing to add or nothing to subtract, right? So I'll simply write x belongs to minus 1 to 2. So this is how we'll solve any rational inequalities.